Republican Senator Ted Cruz has been along the southern border for many days, starting late last week, going out there at night, going on Fox News, recording things documentary style, trying to get a glimpse of all of these migrants allegedly flooding across the southern border. Well, he didn't get much footage of that. He did get a little footage of himself being heckled by people on the other side of the border. But Beto O'Rourke finally came out and articulated in a way what Ted Cruz was doing that few others have been able to do. Right? Here's what happened. Beto O'Rourke, who's a much better, I guess, reply guy than he was candidate for president, came out on social media attacking Ted Cruz and said this. He said, "You're in a Border Patrol boat armed with machine guns. The only threat you face is unarmed children and families who are seeking asylum, as well as the occasional heckler. If you're looking for a crisis to cosplay, Senator, for, I'm happy to point you in the right direction." And that's exactly right, because we've seen the pictures, right? Ted Cruz is in that boat. He's got his bulletproof vest on. He's surrounded by people holding these massive guns. Going down the river, Ted Cruz looking tough, looking like, "I'm going to find me an immigrant, and I don't know what I'm going to do if I find one, but boy, howdy, I'm going to find one." And of course, there's another video. Lindsey Graham's right next to him. He's got his little life jacket on. He's like a little kid who got brought along on dad's fishing trip, even though dad didn't want to bring him, but mom insisted. So that was hilarious. But anyway, Ted Cruz is down there trying to be this big, tough, macho guy. And Beto O'Rourke straight up calls him out and says, "You're cosplaying. You're cosplaying as some kind of like big, tough Rambo senator man, when in reality, you're a coward. You're making up a crisis," because he continues, O'Rourke does. He says, "The truth is the number of individual asylum seekers and immigrants seeking to come to this country is the same or lower than it was in 2019 when Trump was president. This isn't any more of a crisis today than it was then." And he's right about that. There have been plenty of articles coming out in just the last week warning us to, hey, calm down calling it a crisis because it's literally the same as it's ever been. But Ted Cruz understands that most of his supporters aren't going to go and they're not going to read those articles. And if they do, they're going to think it's fake news. So Ted Cruz gets to go down there, play pretend Rio Grande cowboy, and act like he's actually doing something. And it's red meat for the Trump-loving sect of the Republican base. And at the end of the day, let's not forget that this is what this is all about. Ted Cruz right now, in my opinion, is the front runner for the 2024 Republican candidacy. That's what's happening. He absolutely is the front runner. Not necessarily according to polls, but according to himself, putting himself out there, doing these things, constantly being in the headlines, whether it's good or bad, Ted Cruz is being talked about nationally constantly. So yes, he is the front runner, and he's doing things like this to shore up Donald Trump's base so that they don't swing the primary for somebody like Josh Hawley or, you know, any of the other ridiculous human beings that are going to run for the Republican nomination. That's what this is about. That is what Beto O'Rourke called out. But it's not going to stop Ted, because he's going to continue cosplaying as this tough guy to try to win over Donald Trump's base. Because at the end of the day, folks, that is what this new immigration crisis is all about.